Seriously, punch your perfection. I have so much to deal with. I don't want to listen to them fight and fuss and argue.
Ow, my butt's gonna be bruised.
We got lots of things to work on, but all in all, it was good. Minor little bubbles.
She's talking about my kid. I'm done with it.
You're a bow-faced.
No,
I know. You know what?
She said, Mama, Miss Ann called you the B-word, and Andrea called you crazy.
In all honesty, I know Ann thinks there's a team Ann, but there's never been a team Ann. There's been a team we're going to tolerate Ann.
And coming up,
we're going to up our dance, make it a little bit more difficult for Six Flags in St. Louis.
I do not think this is a great idea. I'm going to sit here and sweat and be nervous about it.
They're pretty good.
They are.
I'm a little bit nervous because I don't want their dance to look like a total disaster. The needs to get her freaking out of here now.
Okay.
No. She called me.
No.
Let me tell you one thing right now.
I'm out. These people are crazy.
Shut the hell up.
She can yell at my kid.
If you fall again, I'm going to replace you.
I'm not spending all this money to lose. I'll see anything wrong with living through your child.
We're going to work on our dance today because our score was a little bit low in dance, okay?
That was like our lowest score, wasn't it?
Yes. The Chicago competition went great, but our dance is a little weak. It's the last thing that we worked on and that we put together really fast, so we are changing the choreography again to score us a few more extra points and make the dance better. We're going to up our dance, make it a little bit more difficult for Six Flags in St. Louis.
Yeah!
Wow. Seriously? This weekend, the competition's in Six Flags in St. Louis. And the kids love this trip because they get to go to Six Flags, they get to ride rides together. It's just a good time for the team to bond. Let's get to our dance! Okay, first up, Kylie and Diamond, you gotta learn how to do this. Okay, Dana, come on.
Can y'all do this? I mean, I don't want y'all to get hurt. Just like that!
So, Dana and I decided we wanted to do this new move where they roll over the back and slip their legs and come off the other side. Yeah, that didn't go over so good. It was not a pretty sight. You gotta start right there. All right? Pick your feet up.
I can't!
I did it.
I mean, are we really fixing to change this dance? Are you freaking kidding?
The only thing that we didn't get really high scores on in Chicago was the dance.
As usual, Alisha comes home from competition and decides that she needs to make some changes to the routine. I do not think this is a great idea because we only have like one or two practices before our next competition. So once again, I'm going to sit here and sweat and be nervous about it until I see what happens in St. Louis.
Atrocious. Diamond and Kylie trying to learn a stunt was absolutely tragic. But I knew with time, Diamond and Kylie, they did it right. So it took several tries, a lot of frustration, a lot of falls, but they got it.
That was better.
That was better. I think we can take these outsides to the ground with these, don't you think?
Mm-hmm.
1, 2, 3, 4, roll, 5, 6. We added a few partner stunts at the beginning. We changed the midsection choreography. We made it fast. We added several new things to it. We added some partner stunts right throughout the middle of the dance. Okay, go back to the beginning of your dance. That's cute. All the other competitions and performances that we're doing, that only helps the team. It gives them reassurance that they know this routine's backwards, forwards, sideways, upside down. So that way when we go to Columbus later in the season, we may actually be ready and we can get a U.S. Finals bid. Sounds urban, ain't it?
That was a lot for them this weekend.
Mm-hmm. That was a lot for me.
Then we got to turn around and do it all again.
Yeah.
It's coming up weekend. Swipe it in all day.
It's resting. I'm worn out. You wore me out. I'm so tired. I had an Ann hangover. I swear.
Andrea did great as a roommate this weekend. She totally drove me around everywhere I needed to go. Totally broke rule number 2 when I had to carry my own luggage upstairs. She kept the room very, very clean. She did not go and get me anything to eat or drink when I told her I was thirsty, but hey, rule number 4 broke. We can fix that. And number 5, she woke me up on time. So, you know, 3 out of 5 isn't bad, and those are totally fixable, so we just have to work on it. I was just telling everybody how good you did.
There's only 2 things you gotta work on, and then you'll be the perfect roommate.
I love Ann and Torin to death. I just don't want to room with them or ride in the car with them. ever again.
You're in training.
They're like a natural disaster, like a tornado. I mean, it's all exciting and fun to watch unless you're in the path of destruction, and then you just want to get the hell out of there. It's a nightmare.
Girl, you and Torin, like, I thought me and Kylie were bad button heads.
Torin is scary.
I thought Torin was actually on her best behavior this weekend.
Oh my god.
I thought she did really good.
Torin is frightening when she's mad.
Well,
I was just like afraid that I would wake up to Torin standing over me with a pillow about to snuff me out.
No, she wasn't.
I don't want to see her worse, Ann.
Oh, she has bipolar.
Is that what it is?
I diagnosed her myself.
One, two, three.
Hey, listen, did you know that your mom said that we could never room together again? Do you feel the same way?
Yes.
Brooke fractured a vertebrae. She is healing. We've done physical therapy. She's getting slowly but surely back into tumbling.
I still feel the pain. I mean, it hurts.
Just suck it up. You'll be fine. Turn around. Pay attention.
I don't know Brooke that well. She always looks sad to me, though. She just always looks miserable. I don't even know that she likes tears.
What's going on with her back?
She has that fracture in her vertebrae, and she's always going to have it. It's already closed up as much as it's going to close up.
Oh, my gosh.
She's always going to have a certain amount of pain.
Wow.
She literally was in pain every day, and she doesn't want to go back to that. So that's what's stopping her. That fear of pain. We do physical therapy. You know, we go see that specialist once every 3 months. But it's going to be something she's just going to have to live with.
Gosh, I didn't know.
It's serious.
Yeah.
Brooke's getting back into tumbling. It's much better. But she's got a little bit of a mental block. She needs to change her stinking thinking. If what you think, you become. So if you tell yourself you can't, then you won't. So we've also kind of had to work on that a little bit. You know, kids are resilient. And
so it's okay for her to be doing cheer?
Yes, it is. Trust me. If a doctor told me she could not be on this floor, she wouldn't be here. Nor would Alisha allow her to be here.
I'm sure cheer is more for her mom than Brooke.
You need to pay attention. Coming up.
Oh, my God! You could fight me. I'm going to break your hand. Then you can't cheer at all. Now back up.
Torin smacked her mom a couple of times. That's something I'll talk to Alisha about.
To me. Number one, it's going to be cold. It was just a few days before St. Louis, and there's this huge rainstorm. It's getting cold. This competition's outside, and they're in cheerleading uniforms. What if it's raining? What will we do? I'm afraid that some people may back out and decide it's just too cold to go to Six Flags. I'm also worried about if there'll even be other teams at this competition. Alex, since you weren't at practice last week, you have a whole dance to learn. Why didn't you pick up the phone and call me, and I would have come gotten you?
I ain't got no phone.
You don't have a phone at your house. All right, let's go to the dance. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Alex is in the dead center of the dance formation. She is right in the middle, up front and center, so she's definitely got to know what she's doing. Can y'all make that sharp? I mean, can y'all go like and hit? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3. Their dance was still a little shaky. They need to clean up. They need their transitions to be better. They need to be sharper. And I still want them to perform it just a little bit better. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2.
Girl, Torin is, like, so sick today. I don't know what's wrong with her. She's a little backed up, if you know what I mean.
Oh, ow.
Yeah.
Yikes.
So, not feeling well. I took Torin to the doctor that day, and, you know, the doctor confirmed that Torin kind of was backed up.
Hey, have you pooped yet today?
Torin, I'm going to mess your hair up. I asked Torin, has she gone to the bathroom today, and she didn't take it so well.
Oh, my God! You high-five me.
No, I wouldn't stand back there if I were you. There's a mom about sorry. Ouch! Ouch! I'm not tying your shoe anymore. You have custody to it then. Torn started like punching me and biting me and clawing me with her nails, and she kind of pretty much beat the crap out of me.
Well, I mean, I'm not going to beat my hands and my crap in my pants.
I'm going to break your hands, and then you can cheer it all. Now back up. Torn, stop. I think she embarrassed Torn in front of a group of kids, and Torn reacted, and she smacked her mom a couple of times and tried to bite her, you know, for Anne to embarrass her. To the point that it affects her practice time, you know, that was not a positive thing to do. So that's something I'll talk to Alisha about.
Come here now. Come here.
Okay. All right. I'm going to work on your third eye. Then after we get done with that, you're going to flip over and I'm going to work on your root, which is, of course, is your spine. Okay? So go ahead and lay back. Well, there's a few different things I do with Brooke as far as alternative medicine. Don't get me wrong. The doctors have been awesome. But, you know, I'm all about speeding things up. Oh, really, I need you to be in the moment. So if I have to, you know, shake chicken bones or have crystals laying on my kid's back, if that's what heals her along with what the doctors are doing, sign me up. I'm all about it. You work with the doctors, work with me. Come on.
But they're not weird.
Just work with me. Just hush. Hush. I want you just to deep breathe. Come on. And I've placed a stone on your third eye. It's not funny.
It's
okay. You want to get better?
Yeah.
Okay, then hush. Brooke is really not into the alternative medicine like I am. She thinks I'm off my rocker. Listen. You know what? You defeat the purpose of my work. When she relaxes and accepts it, it works. When she resists, she doesn't accept it and pushes it away, nothing's going to help. Nothing's going to work.
Trust me, you're going to be able to tell the difference. We'll work some more tomorrow. All right?
Okay.
Come on. Go. Shoot. Come here, Bootsy, baby.
Well, spill the beans. What I went on?
Chicago was great. We had a good time. It was her first time flying.
Oh, really?
So she had a ball. I met up with Bonnie and Shannon for dinner. It was really nice to have Shannon there. Shannon has crossed over to join our little group. Competition was great. I mean, there were some good squads there. There were a couple squads that I was nervous about, but it was really good. But I missed y'all the whole time. I thought, you know, this would be a perfect opportunity to see if they want to take a girls' trip. We're going to St. Louis this weekend. I don't know if Chris is going to be able to come. I think y'all should come.
Oh, the girls would love that.
That would be fun.
And I think it'd be good for Elena to actually see what she's got to work towards.
Yeah. I think it's a good idea to take Elena to the St. Louis competition so she can watch you silver perform, to see their routine, and most importantly, their tumbling skills, which she has to have before she's ever going to get on this team.
Yeah, I think it'd be great. Brooke needs a break.
We'll make signs, and we can bring our little cowbells.
It'll be a great time.
We're going to be there to support you silver. We're taking our kids. We're going to go to Six Flags. I think it's going to be a nice little vacation.
It'd be fun. And it would make some other people mad if all of us showed up.
Then
we definitely have to go.
And is kind of outnumbered on this trip. Andrea's not rooming with her. Michelle and Bonnie and I are rooming together. Anne's kind of like all by her little lonesome.
I'm back.
Okay. I know it's this coming weekend. It's Michelle's birthday.
Right.
Uh-huh. So why don't we go ahead and plan her a surprise birthday party?
That's a great idea.
Because she won't be expecting it. Chris is not going to be there, so she won't even think about it.
That's a good idea.
Bonnie and I thought it might kind of help pull a lot of people in the gym together if we had, like, a little surprise party for Michelle.
She'll be really surprised.
She will be surprised. Yeah. Anne will be even surprised, too, because she won't know what's coming.
Yeah.
Coming up.
All right, Torn, go grab your mom and give me two laps.
I'm not going to run laps. I'm an adult that pays you to then teach my kid.
Then don't sit here.
Torn, let's go.
I don't know if me and Torn's going to come back.
outside for just a few minutes?
Sure. Okay, thank you.
You gonna beat me up?
No, I'm not gonna beat you up.
Okay.
I'll get physical.
Why are we going outside?
Just to get away from everybody.
Oh, okay.
So we can be in private.
Okay, I just have a question for you. The other day, a situation that happened with Ann and Torin. There was an incident that happened in the gym that I feel needs to be addressed, you know, to the coaches. I don't think that they were aware.
So what happened?
Ann kind of embarrassed her in front of everybody, and, you know, and then her slapping her mom a few times and trying to bite her. And
that happened in the gym?
Yes, we were sitting in the red chairs. I just wanted to say, hey, this was brought to my attention by my daughter. Have you been to the gym today? I was there. I know you were busy, so I felt it was appropriate to let her know. All the kids saw it. All the parents that were sitting over there were kind of, you know, taken aback that, first of all, she's smacking her mom, and then Ann got upset, and she's like, you know, if you don't stop, I'm going to beat your butt.
I like to know what's going on in the gym. Of course, I want to be very nosy because I want to know everything that happens. I don't want that kind of behavior in the gym. And I didn't obviously know what was going on.
Yeah, and I knew you were teaching. And
I thought Torin was sick because that's what they said to me. Oh, she doesn't feel good. We know here I am dragging her out on the floor.
For Ann to embarrass her to the point that it affects her practice time, you know, that was not a positive thing to do. That, to me, is not very positive if you're going to embarrass your kid.
I appreciate Michelle pulling me to the side and telling me what happened because I can't see everything. And I'm glad you came to me because, I mean, this is important to us. Right. And I want to make sure that we're on the right path. And if kids are noticing it, then we obviously have to do something about it.
Right. Incident that happened needs to be addressed. I hope Ann is punished or talked to.
Thank you.
No, thank you. Fighting in the gym the other day. A mom and a daughter. Can anyone tell me who was doing that?
Oh, good heavens.
Who was it, Torin? Oh, it was you? You were fighting with your mom. Michelle had come and talked to me about Ann and Torin getting in a fight in the gym. I like to know what's going on in the gym. I appreciate Michelle pulling me to the side and telling me what happened because, you know, I'm always on the floor running around doing other teams and I can't see everything.
Okay, so what happens when team members fight? What do we make y'all do? What'd you say, Stucky?
Run.
All right, Torin, go grab your mom and give me two laps. Can't have any fighting in the gym. Two laps.
I gotta run two laps.
Fighting in the gym.
I ain't fighting in the gym.
Two laps.
Are you kidding?
No, I'm not kidding. Two laps.
Alisha marched herself right over to Ann and brought Torin and was like, Ann, Torin, get up, run two laps for me. I thought I was going to pass out. She was pissed.
Come on, Ann, take off your heels.
I'm not taking off my heels.
Well, then run in your heels.
Alisha came over there, and I guess she expected me to get right up on demand and run these couple laps for her, but I just wasn't having it. There's no way. I mean, Alisha wasn't going to embarrass me like that in front of the gym. You know, I pay Alisha a lot of money, or my husband pays Alisha a lot of money, and, you know, he doesn't pay her to punish me. He pays her to teach Torin.
Girls, what do we do if we fight and disagree?
What we fight about had, we didn't even fight. What we said had nothing to do with the gym.
What you fought about wasn't about the gym, but it took place in the gym.
I'm not running around this gym.
Go, Torin, run your laps.
You gotta run four, because your mom will run two.
She got really upset because I asked her to run some laps. And I was trying to make her understand, and all the other parents sitting there, that do not fuss and fight in this gym. That's all I asked. Who are you calling?
Calling Tori. Hey, come into the gym, please.
Okay.
Bye. So I'm not talking until Tori gets here.
Well, you gotta use Tori to talk?
It's a family matter.
Then Alisha made a comment like, what, you gotta call your husband and have him fight your battles for you? Oh my God. I could feel the heat radiating off of her. Like, it got really hot in that gym really fast.
But it was in the gym.
But it's a family matter.
I don't care if it was a family matter. It was right here. Well, I mean, what am I supposed to do about it?
Well, I'm not going to run laps.
Well, okay, what's a fair punishment for you?
What do you mean a punishment?
I was very caught off guard by her reaction. And I think she was completely caught off guard by mine. And it just kind of, my ears just started smoking and so did hers. And it just went from there.
I'm an adult that pays
pays you to then teach my kid.
Then don't sit here.
Well, I can take her out of the gym and not come at all.
Okay.
Torin, let's go. My blood pressure was extremely high. I was very upset and disappointed with Alisha as a friend and as a coach. I felt like instead of getting up and scratching her eyeballs out, that I was going to jump up and just grab Torin and leave the gym. Torin, let's go.
All right, guys, let's go. Let's practice. She got really upset with me, really, really, really mad with me, and her and Torin left the gym.
Wow. I can't believe that just happened. That's the kind of person that she wants to be and embarrass me in front of, you know, in the gym and, you know, try to screw up my status at the gym, then, you know, maybe that's not the right place for me and Torin to be. You know, I'm very upset with Alisha and the gym, and as of now, I don't know if me and Torin's going to come back.
Missed everything that happened. I just wanted to talk to y'all about it and kind of get y'all's side and kind of just resolve the problem.
I called Ann, you know, to find out what she was so upset about, what had happened. Her and Tori came up to the gym so we could kind of work everything out.
Well, basically, like, I found out who all this came up through.
Okay.
And apparently, she's, like, one of my worst enemies here at the gym.
Who?
Michelle. And I'm very upset because I feel like she's trying to start trouble again. Here she is again, trying to start trouble with me. My feelings were very, very hurt that she's gone to Alisha and has said, you know, that I need to be in trouble. I think that if it was anybody else, I would have tattletaled. Andrea, Mandy, I mean, maybe even Shannon at this point. I don't think I would have got quite as upset, you know, but with the past that me and Michelle has, which just like she was, you know, irking to stab somebody in the back.
We do not allow you to discipline your child in the gym. Fighting in the gym, I get on to the kids over and over. Do not fuss, do not kick, do not blah, 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 blah. So I just came up with what was a simple punishment. I didn't think about the whole Michelle thing.
Where I totally feel like it comes from, you know? It's just her way of getting at me again. I mean, how do you expect me to get along with her? You know what I mean? I just don't know what to do.
This. I think the tension between the two of them has just been built up years after years after year. And now they're having to see face to face again. And it's just, the tension's just like, neither one of them know how to handle it.
I think that's a personal thing between you and Michelle. And y'all need to resolve that in some way. I mean, and just, let's keep it out of the gym, you know?
I agree.
I understand y'all have issues, but that is between y'all.
You better. You better?
I'm good.
Are you running laps?
No, I'm not running laps.
Seriously.
Everything packed?
Yep.
The serious ones?
Yep. I made sure. Are we there yet? How much longer?
Like 5 hours or so. But y'all gotta stop and pee every 10 minutes.
No, we
so
don't.
Six, seven
We're not
hours.
Drinking.
No. I can't do rain.
It's sprinkling.
I know, but it makes me nervous.
Well, it don't look.
We are headed to Six Flags in St. Louis, but I'm kind of nervous because it's cold outside and it's been raining, and I'm really nervous that people aren't going to show up.
This is so uncomfortable. This is the like, most boring view ever. It's just dirt and birds.
You complain about too much.
The silence is golden, but duct tape is silver.
I did have to listen to my child yap and flap her gums the whole time.
La, 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 la.
Kylie, oh my God.
I'm passing a story about a little girl and her mother ignores her the whole way on a trip.
Kylie, oh my gosh.
So this weekend, I expect a different attitude from you.
Okay.
Because last weekend in Chicago, you were not very good. It's like when you're hanging around Torin, you act bad.
Okay, okay. Can you hold this back?
Hey, seriously, don't think all it is for just, a few minutes?
The car ride to St. Louis, Tori was driving, and so I was excited that my husband was with me. I'm glad, Tori, that you are coming this weekend.
What?
To take care of me. Nobody took care of me last weekend. Andrea was not a very good roommate.
Meaning what?
Well, I mean, you know, she wouldn't get my bags and put it in the room.
Get your bag.
And then she was driving, and she wouldn't let me drive, Tori.
And you said you can't drive.
She couldn't drive either. What are you doing?
Oh, my God, seriously, how much longer? I can't take it.
A long time. It's only 3 o'clock.
When are we going to stop and eat? I need a snack.
I called Ann while we were on the road just to check on them and see how everybody was behaving in their car.
Can you make the car be a little quieter? Because I can't really hear.
Are you serious?
From Bonnie, inviting everybody on Eve Silver to a birthday party, a surprise party for Michelle.
Andrea calls me and she's talking about the surprise party for Michelle, and I'm like, what in the world are you talking about?
Oopsie. Are you sure? Check your inbox. Are you sure you didn't get it?
Everybody on Youth Silver was invited but Anne.
Are you serious? You really didn't get it, Anne?
No, Andrea, I'm not lying.
I'm sorry. Come on now, I'm the only one not invited. It's all back to freaking junior high school days, you know, who's who and who's going to be invited.
She's going to invite the whole rest of the team.
I was like, yes, girl. That straight up just happened.
I'm sorry. I feel bad for saying anything now.
I kind of felt bad, but then I kind of thought it was funny.
You need to crash the party. You should totally crash the party.
I will totally crash the party. It doesn't bother me whether she likes that I'm there or not. I'll be the first one in line for that birthday cake.
All right, girl. I will talk to you when we get there tonight.
You know, Anne is all worried about her mom's status. Maybe her mom's status got knocked down a few notches today, so she's probably a little upset about that.
Oh, gosh. Are we there yet? Because I need to get out of the car. And I'm for real going to have a panic attack.
Coming up.
I'm nervous because I don't want their dance to look like a total disaster.
Showtime Revolution!
No, she called me out. I'm going to tell you one thing right now.
Competition. It's an outdoor event. The whole way up here, it rained. The girls are in their little uniforms. They're freezing to death. They're just going to have to suck it up and get out there and just do it.
So it's competition morning, and, you know, we're walking through Six Flags, getting to the back where the competition is being held, and, you know, we're walking back there, and I'm seeing the other cheerleaders, so I'm getting a little bit concerned, and we come around the corner, and, like, I see one team there to compete.
It is cold. We'll warm up.
We get in there. There were some people there to do individuals, group stunts, things like that. They just were not in competition with Youth Silver.
Midwest Twin Stars, you guys will take the floor, warm up.
I was very shocked that there wasn't any more teams there.
Alisha, did some teams drop out because of the weather?
Mm-hmm. I know that there were several that didn't want to drive through the storm. And then they said it was going to be cold today. Very cold. Even if the other teams drop out because of the weather, Youth Silver's still performing. It doesn't matter what the weather is, doesn't matter how much competition we have, we need to get out there and perform. It's always good. The more performances you have, the better they get each time. So that way when we go to Columbus, they know this routine forwards, backwards, sideways, upside down.
Rain, sleet, snow, or shine, Cheertime Revolution will be there.
Always.
Like the U.S. Postal Service.
The competition wasn't as big as we wanted it to be. We didn't have the teams to compete against that we wanted. The weather was horrible, and I'm certain that that's what, you know, teams started dropping out left and right.
Good morning, everyone. I'd like to welcome you to the 2012 Six Flags St. Louis competition. For our youth best jump from Midwest Twin Stars, give it up for Paley.
some individuals, stunt groups. I was like, really got my mind to thinking. We've got talented kids, so I thought for the next competition, why not take a few kids and take some individual stunt groups and see how they compete like that. Hey, guys, that stunt, Namaya, can be better. I'm a little bit nervous because I don't want their dance to look like a total disaster. They're freezing. You know, their muscles aren't warmed up and it's cold outside. It's hard to get their bodies to move in the way that they normally move in normal temperatures.
Please help me welcome the floor. Cheer time, revolution!
Was stellar. It was awesome. I was so proud.
They totally cleaned it up. I was very, very impressed with them. They know their routine. They nailed it. They were tight. They were sharp. It was a good comp. I was very impressed.
Y'all fought for it good. Y'all fought really good. Hey, your routine was actually much cleaner this time than it was last time. It was a great performance, and I'm glad we took the risk and changed the dance right before competition, and they nailed it.
All competitors from today's competition, please report to the floor. You, level two division.
Here we go. Look at this.
First place.
You silver pulled it out again this weekend, and we won first place again. Of course we won. I mean, there was no competition there.
All right, guys, so y'all won again. I mean, your routine was actually very, very, very good. I can see improvement on your dance, and I can see improvement on the back stunt, but you were cleaner this competition. Much cleaner this competition than you were last time. I think the team learned a lot of things being there. Regardless of the size of the competition, the team knows that they got to go out there and they've got to try their very hardest and they got to give it their all. And they did that. You know, they could have gone out there and looked very sloppy and not really wanted to perform because who did they have to perform for? But instead, they went out there and they worked hard. It was freezing cold and they gave it their all. We got to see some neat individuals, stunt routines, tumble off. Maybe we should try to go find a competition that does that?
Yes.
I think that'd be fun. All right, now, since y'all did good, I guess it's time to go run roller coaster. We're in St. Louis, and we're planning a surprise party for Michelle for her birthday.
There you go. How come everybody's got to be late?
How you going in?
Surprise! Y'all are too crazy.
Yes, you're so silly.
I walk in, and Bonnie's there, and Alisha and Arnie jump out from behind this little screen. And there's a cake and balloons and party hats, and it was really nice.
Nobody ever really causes any trouble.
Alisha.
Hi!
Oh,
what's up, girl?
Happy birthday, beautiful
thank
girl.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Some on this side. What is that? Ready? Just eat all the food before everybody gets here.
Yeah. I wasn't invited, but happy birthday.
Thank you.
I'm pretty too.
First of all, I didn't invite Anne to this party because Michelle doesn't like her. I don't like her. Shannon doesn't like her. Why would you crash a party that you were not wanted at? She had no place being there. We'll just eat all the food before everybody gets here.
I wasn't invited, but happy birthday.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
We get to the party. We're all hanging out. Then Ann walks in. Why would you crash a party that you were not wanted at? She had no place being there.
It was totally priceless when I walked through those doors. Everybody's mouth dropped, you know. I was offering my hand to pick the dolls up off the ground and put it back in their face. And it was totally awesome.
Come here. I need to go outside for a second.
Y'all run away.
Come with me.
Okay, do I need to watch my mouth to get her out of here now.
Okay, she wasn't invited.
She was not invited, and Michelle can't stand her. I am livid.
All I can say is I'm not going to hold you back. You do whatever you feel like you need to do. I just can't believe she actually came.
Do I call her out here? Because I really don't think I should bust her out in front of everybody in there.
Yes, I would call her out here and say, okay, but sorry you weren't invited. I appreciate that you came, but, you know, Michelle is not comfortable with you being here.
Yeah.
She can't relax and be herself.
No, so I shouldn't say, get your out of here because she can't stand.
I mean, you gotta let your freak flag fly, I guess.
I swear, there's little horns coming out of my red hair. My face was getting red. I was just so angry. I could not hold it in, and I had to let Anne have it.
I didn't even know.
Because Michelle can't stand you, and half the people here cannot stand you. You need to carry your ass out of here and leave.
Can I have a glass of wine, please?
Bonnie's face was as red as her hair. I couldn't figure out which one was which. And she starts yelling at me to get my butt up and to leave, that, you know, I'm not invited there and nobody there wants me and I wasn't going anywhere. After what this wicked woman has done to you and done to several people, she is not welcome here. She had some damn nerve to show her up in here.
I think Bonnie being upset, she had every right to be. This is something she organized and orchestrated. So leaving Ann and her husband off of the invite list was totally her prerogative. You know, she knows that I don't like them. They don't care for me. So why would they want to come and celebrate a moment for me?
Can I just ask one question? I just want to know why I wasn't invited.
I think we covered that, Blondie. You heard what I said. I don't stutter. Y'all think maybe for the end of the season we could all be friends?
Yes.
No.
As far as being friends, that's not going to happen.
And really ticked me off right now, and I'm on that bandwagon of you put it out there, you dish it out. Well, you know what? It's my turn to tell you how to cow eat the cabbage, and it's time for you to feel what it's like when you do this to us.
You disrespect me, straight up, and you know
say that.
No. She called me up. So let me tell you one thing right now.
You're gonna creep over here and do what?
Shut the hell up! Shut the hell up! Shut the hell up!
Next time on Cheer Perfection.
I can't do all this.